Yeah, I don't know. It's like, I don't know. It's, yeah, it's like, I think live action is different than anime. I think it's much easier to find someone attractive if it's live action because, I don't know.
Because they're real.
Yeah, I guess.
In terms of animation, again, I'm thinking of other characters. Like, I love the Legend of Korra, but I've never had a crush on Korra. You know? I just loved her as a character.
Zuko, I used to have a massive crush on Zuko from the first one.
Oh, he is that emo kind of
But
guy.
it wasn't when he first came. It's when he cut rid of that horrible ponytail and had his hair. Yeah.
When
From
did he
then
do
on.
that? Was it like the second season?
It was like after he when it was when they were when the, him and his uncle were in hiding from the Fire Nation and his sister and his dad because
Was that season three?
I think it was season three or later season two. I can't remember. It's been a
Yeah,
very long
it has been
time.
a while since I've seen the original Avatar series.
Because I do know his sister. I don't think his sister came into season two. I think she was in season one, was she? Or she.
That might be right. Or
Oh, I can't
if she was in
remember.
season one, they'd have mentioned her, maybe not seen her.
They mentioned. Oh, she's been mentioned. She was always mentioned. I will say that she was like always mentioned through the entire time. Yeah, but I don't think I had a crush on anybody in Korra. Actually, no. Sammy and Korra. I'm not a lesbian, but them, the two of them.
Make a perfect couple.
They, yeah, because Mako was a fucking idiot. And
Oh.
I guess I think my favorite character was actually my favorite character. I think you know who my favorite characters were in Korra. I can't remember if you remember though.
Give me one
It
second to
wasn't
think.
like any. They weren't the main characters at all. It was a duo, and they weren't the main characters. They were like comedy relief.
It's not like those two twins from like.
It was this big salesman guy and his assistant.
Oh.
They were my favorite.
Wow. Yeah, I know who you're talking about.
Yeah, they were my favorites. They just showed up for random things and he was like, the tea! And she was like, come out with a pot of tea. Yeah, it was just, they were funny.
Yeah. They were great,
They
yeah.
were my favorite characters, actually.
God, I need to get the new Korra comic. I have the first Korra comic,
Oh,
but
really?
I haven't actually gotten the second one.
I just realized my health was full. I didn't need that, but oh well.
Well, you got points for it, which if you get enough points, you get an extra life, you see. So that's why you'd want to collect points, not just for like a vanity issue.
Okay, how much points do you need to get an extra life?
I'm not sure. Maybe 10,000?
Oh, but I already have over 10,000.
Yeah, you got an extra life, right? But didn't
But
you start
that.
off with two?
Oh.
So I'm not sure. We could check next time.
I can't remember. I know I got one from.
Did you?
I got one from fighting an enemy
Did you
in.
start with two or three? I thought it was two.
I don't know. We'll check in a bit. We'll check it. If I die again, we'll check. Probably will die again.
You're gonna get this though. I believe in you. Eventually. Those guys you should just hop over. I don't
I
think you have enough
know.
time to actually shoot and kill them. Like.
Wait, okay. These. I just jumping at these things.
Yeah, you are struggling with them, oddly enough.
Okay. Too bad that you can't heal. Healing would be nice. Healing would be
That
nice.
actually applies to most Mega Man games, though. Well, maybe not most. Actually, so in some of the later Mega Man games, they actually brought in what's called E-tanks. And they're like things you can fill up beforehand with energy, and you can use them to heal yourself in battle.
And I died.
But you have to prepare yourself in advance.
Okay.
Know what I mean? But the early Mega Man games, they did not have that.
I'm shaking my hand when they do this. Right.
Oh my god.
Don't ask me how I did that.
That was crazy.
It was, wasn't it?
Sorry, I was speechless for a bit.
Yeah. I did this. Oh.
But I can you? Oh, you can.
If I aim it properly.
Oh, okay. But stand over there. Yeah, do it there. And if you, oh, I don't know if you can reach him with that though. It's too far away.
Okay. No, I have to do. I'll have to do this now. If I start it here. Shit. Oh fuck. Oh no. Shit.
Oh god. I'm doing the tight chest thing again.
I'm not gonna get this lucky again. Oh my god, no.
Remember you can double jump.
I know. Shit, I turned. I'm gonna wait for him to hit. And then do a double jump, okay. I jumped into it!
Oh.
Okay. Okay.
God.
Okay, I got really lucky because the vines were on the ground and that's how I was able to do that.
Yeah.
Okay, again.
Oh man, you're so close.
Oh.
Wow, you actually...
Oh, oh, I meant to go to the water. I don't know why, I'm stupid.
So from this angle you could have...
Oh, I jumped in, correct. Okay.
You did it like from this angle or something, didn't you?
Yes! There, got that one. And then... I'm not turning the right way.
But I don't see how you can hit him up there.
I didn't. I think they were like on the ground.
Or both of them.
I think they were. And because then when I hit him, he was already in the tack, so it went straight to hitting his mouth.
Okay. Just before you... Actually, wait now.
We'll just...
I'll wait until...
Yeah, we'll wait. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, like this?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, do it and then keep it held because you're going to... Get a bit closer. No! You okay, that was good.
Oh, okay, turn the wrong way. That was a risk. I took that risk. Okay.
Oh god. Okay, and yeah, you're really struggling to hit these guys, which is interesting because you have double jump.
I know, I just find it awkward. Okay. I have one more chance.
And I would love to see you play Ori and the Blind Forest.
Why?
That is a gorgeous game, really good, but it is quite difficult.
Oh, okay, I didn't do it that correctly that time.
And why are you...
I'm doing it wrong again. Don't ask me why.
It's okay. And then, yeah.
Throw it in the corner, no.
Okay. You take quite a bit of damage from doing that, though. But...
Ah, shit.
You were going down there.
I know, that was an error.
It's gonna be hard. Can you hit him with that? I don't know if you... Okay. You see, there's so much setup there, that's why...
Yeah, that's why it was actually perfect if I did the other times, because I'm already doing
yeah.
it.
Yeah, so you just absolutely did a ton of damage there.
That's why I would love to recreate that again.
Well, what you could do, actually, if you could get rid of the one up on the wall first, you could take down the other one with that, and
true.
Then you'd be able to absolutely wreck.
And I just did, so I have to do this all over again.
Okay, one thing I'd like to just check... I just want to teach you how to properly double jump.
Okay.
Just before you progress, because I think that could help.
Okay.
A lot of this stuff comes down to the basics.
I was pressing square because of Chantley.
It's okay. Yeah, I know. It can be confusing going between games.
Okay.
Okay, so what you want is a full jump. Just press... Yeah, do you see? So you hold at, and then you hit it and hold it again.
Oh, okay. Oh, see... Okay, I'll get it.
Yeah, it just takes practice. You know what I mean?
Yay!
Oh, that was a good conversation topic.
I start with a 3.
Oh, okay, I'm wrong then.
It must be 20,000.
Maybe. I feel like I remember getting life by getting points. That's how a lot of these older games worked. Like, actually, have you ever heard of Ninja Gaiden?
Yes, I have. My friends used to love it, so I watched some of them play it. And also, isn't Ayane from Dead or Alive in Ninja Gaiden?
But when you say you watched people play
it. My friends had it.
Are you talking about the 3D versions, the ones that were made for Xbox?
I think so, yeah.
Because I'm talking the original NES.
No.
Okay. But that's a game, I think, where you got more lives by... Because what would happen in that one is if you lost all of your lives, you go back to the very beginning of the game.
Oh god,
That's how a lot of early games worked. Like, if you played the older Sonic games, they're easier compared to some other ones, but if you lose all your lives, you go right back to the beginning of the game.
That kind of sucks.
Yeah. Well, it was a way to, like, get value back then, you see, because...
True. I guess games were kind of shorter there.
Very short, yeah, and they were expensive.
Games are still expensive. I actually think games are more expensive than they used to be.
Well, they're more expensive in our lifetime, that is true. But back then, I think they were saying, like, your average game would be the modern equivalent of, like, $110 or something.
Wow.
Because of inflation?
I remember when the Spyro Remaster came out, I think I told you that, I pre-ordered it, but I was at work, I think, when it came out. And I asked my dad, hey, when you finish work, can you pick it up for me? It's already pre-ordered, it's already paid for. You just have to, like, go in with my GameStop.
Card,
and just give it to them, and they would find the pre-order on it. And my dad said okay, and he went and got it, and he came home, and he was like, because it was paid for, but he saw the receipt, and he was like, it was 80 euro.
It was?
No, it wasn't. It was 50 euro.
€50.
And he was like, Caitlin, the game was 50 euro. That's really dear. And I was like, no, that's really cheap.
Well. Really, like, cheap might be an exaggeration.
To me,
like,
it is, because I think games are like 80 now, and I just died. Of course I did.
Well, it depends. Like, I don't tend to buy games at full price in general, just because I have so many lined up.
I do. You are aware of that already.
Yeah. Like, a lot of... If I'm likely to buy a game at full price, it'll be because they're, like, starting out pretty cheap. Like, for instance, the Hat in Time. I don't know if you've heard of a Hat in Time.
I have heard of it, yeah.
That like brand new was $27.99.
That's very cheap.
And you get a really good 3D platform out of it.
Yeah, like I do remember like telling my dad like games are about 80 euro upwards normally.
Yeah.
And like, and when I looking back, when I got like Final Fantasy X, I'm pretty sure it was only like 30-35 euro.
But also that wasn't brand new at the time.
No, it wasn't, but I think every game I used to buy was only around 30 to 40, like, games. I remember, because I bought Persona 4 when it came out, and I'm pretty sure Persona 4 was, like, 50 or something.
50 makes sense to me.
Yeah.
But then again, yeah.
And that was for a new game.
I don't know how it works. Like, I guess if you'd, like, tracked, like, how
And that was also, like, that game, I'm pretty sure Persona 4 was definitely 80 hours plus.
Oh, Persona 4 is such a big game.
Oh, gameplay. And that wasn't Golden. That was like...
Yeah, Golden had more content.
And then with Golden, you were probably looking more like 90 hours plus with Golden. If you wanted to go for everything.
Like, yeah, like, what was the new stuff in Golden? You had that new
dungeon. You had the extra character, and there was a couple of extra scenes because of that new character, and there was that extra dungeon, yes.
You had a new social link, right? Not just with her, but with a policeman, right?
Yes, you did. Yes, you did have a new social link with that police person as well.
Yeah.
So you had two social links. So yeah, so it was a longer game, but it was already a long game. Like, but so for it was about 50 euro. I'm pretty sure it was 50. Could have been 55. And that was new out at the time, I remember. Because I remember it being
out of sight.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I'm talking and I just got distracted. I remember it being a new game because it took up an entire, so it was like around the time where GameStop's, where they had like all, it, like the entire wall was full of like the same, it's like different now where they only have like one or two out and be like, just bring this up.
Mm-hmm.
But all of the discs were like on the wall and that just showed how many were left. Do you remember those days?
It was. I have a vague idea of it. I remember when I was younger, I misunderstood.
Gosh, shit!
No! Okay.
Okay, I have a second chance to do it. Okay.
But when I was younger, you know how in GameStops they would have they'd have it numbered like 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
That was to show what was best selling.
I remember that being there, it was like there and it was like. But I remember it was new because it took up like an entire wall. And that's how I remember Persona 4 being very new out at the time.
But when I was younger, I misunderstood it as a kid. I actually thought it meant that was the best games.
Oh.
Obviously, like, that was completely wrong.
Yes.
But in my mind, I was like...
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, if you... Okay, make sure you get...
No!
Did you let go or did you get hit?
I got hit.
You got hit. Like how we guessed at the same time.
Okay.
Just...
Ah, so close.
All you have to do is hit it twice. All you have to do is hit it twice. You don't even need to, like,
Shit.
Yeah, stay out of the way. Jump. All you have to do is take...
Oh, heck. I knew they were too kind to me.
Oh, God. No, I don't risk that at all.
Yeah.
Because you can't dodge if you do that.
And I died.
Oh!
Okay, and I only have one more try. Okay.
Oh man, that went so well though.
I know, my thumb is really sore. But yeah, so games were very cheap when we were younger compared to now. I don't know why I did that. I jumped too soon.
It's okay. Well, they were comparatively cheap, I should say. If we take inflation into account, maybe...
True.
I don't know. I haven't tracked, like, you know, how much inflation-wise, you know, is this compared to today or something.
Don't know. It's like... I just know games now, I think, €80 plus for a new game.
Yeah. But
that isn't indie.
But what I was... Like, something... Like, I remember Jim Ryan. Do you know Jim Ryan?
What does he do?
He's the head of PlayStation.
Okay, yeah.
He was talking before about, you know, video game prices, and he was like, oh, you know, compared to movies and everything else, like, video games represent the best value in terms of, like, and he was like, that's why they should be priced more. And I was like, on one hand, I get what you're saying. Like, you know, if you get a really big game, like, compared to a movie,
like, I'm not gonna lie, like I said, Persona 3 Portable is on Steam for £20. Okay, I get it's portable, they did get rid of a lot of the cutscenes, and I am frustrated with it. But you still get all that gameplay for €20, and I actually think, I think they priced it too low.
But...
Personally, even though they got rid of the cutscenes, which is annoying, for the amount of time you get from the game, they priced it too low.
But one thing that I also go back to, you see, is that there is a difference in someone's head of, like, paying a large sum up front as opposed to paying a small amount, like, even if the small amount ends up being more expensive, like, just having a big flat sum up front can be off-putting. Like, I remember when we were talking,
but like €20 is still really low.
No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the €80.
Oh yeah,
like, I remember, do you know the manga Battle Angel Alita?
Yes, I've heard of it. Yeah.
So there's a box set you can get of it. And the box set represents the best value for it. It's like about £100.
Okay.
That's for like was it 9 volumes? Which is across 6 hardback, like large, like, volumes. Like, it's a very special edition. And like, from a value perspective, yes, that is the best. But I remember talking to someone about it. And when I told them it was 100, they were very like, ooh, you know?
No, it's 100 volume. It's €100 for how many volumes?
So it would have been 9 originally in Japanese, but I think the way they re-released it, they did 6 volumes with, like, you know, each was a volume and a half long. And it was, like, this high.
€100 for an entire manga series? No, I don't think that's bad at all.
Yeah, but I think there is something to do with, like, that upfront cost.
I think if you're very new into those kind of hobbies, I think, yeah. But if you're a person, like, we've been collecting manga, anime for years, I would say that's perfectly reasonable.
Oh yeah, it is perfectly reasonable.
As in, I actually think that's a deal.
Because they're hardback and they're massive.
Yeah. Oh, they're also hardback? Okay, yeah, no, that's a deal.
Yeah, and they're, like, they're this big in terms of, like, trim size.
Yeah, like, yeah, so, yeah, like, no, that's a deal. My guess is, like, it depends how into a hobby you are, because Lego, I think, is, like, insanely overpriced. Now, I love playing with Lego myself, but, like, when you don't...
Oh, yeah.
But then people buy it, like...
Well, when I was a kid, Warhammer was a thing I was really into.
Oh, yeah, like, I never said that this channel, but you know, I'm into like doll collecting, and I like collected Monster High dolls and like.
Do you want to cut this out or?
No, you're fine.
Okay.
If you want to add it in, you can. It's up to you. Okay. I collect them, and like they can be really expensive if you get collector ones. And
people, oh, of course.
And I remember being at work, and one of the new Monster High doll like collector dolls dropped, and I can't remember which one it was, but it was going to be about €80, and that included the shipping from the US to America. Now, obviously, then I'd also have to pay imports. So I think normally when I buy them, they're about the entire total is a little bit over 100 with import and shipping and everything. But people, I remember one of the lads, I was like, because they would sell out within like 2 or 3 minutes sometimes, not always. The most recent one didn't sell out because not many people wanted it.
Which one was that?
It was the new Frankie. She just wasn't as pretty. She sold. I don't even know if she sold out yet. She hadn't sold out in nearly a week, I'm pretty sure. I got her. But I remember when I brought the Hong Kong Dracula Laura, she sold out in under 3 minutes.
Wow. Well, I was thinking more of the Disney ones. Like
the Disney ones are really expensive. They're 130.
They're the ones you really talk to me about.
Yeah, but they don't sell out as fast sometimes, depending. Depending on the collection, like the most recent collection didn't, not many people liked it. So, but then their 16 inch dolls do sell out faster.
Oh, Caitlin. Sorry, I'm getting excited.
I know.
Wrong way.
Oh shit! Okay. But
sorry,
yeah.
I'm sorry for cutting in, but this is so fine. Close.
But no, but basically, I remember one of the lads at work was saying I paid €80 for a doll. Mm-hmm.
They must have been flabbergasted.
They thought that was ridiculous. And they were like, who pays that for a doll? And I was like, well, clearly a lot of people, since they sell out in like 3 minutes.
Yeah.
Perfect. A lot of people do.
Last thing, demand.
Demand, yeah. Like, so it depends, but like people listening to, if anyone listens to this, they're probably like, is she mad? No. Like I said, the Beetlejuice dolls I bought, if I want to buy them now, they're about over 300 on eBay when I only paid, with import and everything and shipping, I only paid about like just about 110 in total, I think.
Yeah, but also think of all those little like figurines that people collect sometimes. Like, yeah. I'm not even talking
pop
about
figures. One of my friends is really into pop figure collecting.
Yeah, but I'm not even talking about pop figures. I'm talking about the more traditional, like the something your grandmother might have collected.
Oh, it's like, I know,
ceramic.
It's like my Precious Moments figures. I'm pretty sure in the States, the Precious Moments figures, they're like old figures from like the 80s or something, or 60s. And they've been stuff their grandparents had. They're like really popular, and some of them are worth loads of money.
Yeah, but I bet they were also really expensive.
At the time, but I think now if you go to thrift stores, they're could be cheaper.
Yeah.
But you can sell them online.
For a lot of money. Yeah. And I'm just saying there, like, that's the same thing. It's because you collect it and it's because it makes you happy.
Yeah, yeah. Like, it's like Lego. It's like, there's always going to be a community, like, so, like, I know to my going to Smith's to buy, like, the Playline dolls, because I collect those too. Now, they're cheaper, but, and I do take those out of box. Sometimes like staff would tell me what they collect. Like I know one person at our local Smiths is really into Lego. Oh god, another girl is really into like all those blind box stuff, like the mini brands.
Oh yeah.
And they just like it's interesting just hearing what they tell me they collect, because people just collect
random like
things.
I actually have a couple of Overwatch blind boxes over here.
Yeah, like it's just really.
They were reduced, and it was like, well, you know, if they're 250, then
yeah. Sure. Like, oh, sometimes like, yeah, blind box stuff can be fun.
The risk, of course, is you get the same thing.
Oh yeah, I was in Smith recently, and I bought a blind box thing when I was looking to see if they had like the new Rainbow High dolls in, and they didn't at that time. They did the 2 weeks later, but when I went in, I was like, oh, blind box stuff, and I was like, I never had these before. I never did one, so I was like, yeah. Why not do it? So I got a Miraculous Ladybug one with the Kiwamis.
Oh! Okay, just be careful. Sorry.
I know. I actually have a good bit of health though, so I'm slightly more confident.
I wouldn't even like risk you using that move, because you're very vulnerable when that happens, you know?
True.
I just focus on shooting, because you just do 2 shots in his tonsils, he's dead. Know what I mean?
True. You gotta be kidding me. The game hates me.
Hey, Caitlin.
What?
You hit one each of them once. Hit it! Hit it! Oh my god, you did. Yay! You actually went for the special move. I just wanted you to shoot twice.
I just, because I knew with jumping I would be. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Okay, sorry, everyone. That took a very long time.
Sorry. Oh my god.